Hello, welcome back to Knowledge Mining Platform. In this lab, we are going to create a cognitive search enrichment process with text skills. In previous lab, we already deployed our cognitive search and worked with the indexer. Now, what we are going to do is integrate natural language processing to analyze images and extract text from documents or from images, detecting language, entities, key phrases, sentiment, and more. So at the end, our Azure Cognitive Search Index will have additional content using the text skills. For this lab, we are going to use Postman, using the post method to request and to create the data source. So first, we'll create the data source using Postman from the storage account created in previous module. We're going to add a skill set, an index, indexer, and also check the status of the indexer and test it executing search within our cognitive service. Okay, so the first thing is using Postman, I will create a new request. Let me go to new. Request. This is going to be my Azure Cognitive Search. Optionally, we can include description. Now I will add a new collection, same name. Perfect. And save this request in the Azure Cognitive Search collection. Perfect. The method to use now is a post. We want to create a data source. And the endpoint, we are going to find it within the overview of our Azure search. I already have it open, the search service created in previous lab. Here is the URL, the name of the resource, search.windows.net. I'll go back to Postman. And now, as mentioned, what we want to do now is create the data source within this cognitive search. Therefore, the endpoint will be data sources and need to specify the API version. For this demo, we'll use the 2019-05-06-preview. Perfect. Now, in the header, we are going to include two headers, the content type and the API key. Let's go first with the content type, and the value for the content type will be JSON, application/JSON. Actually, you can see it has IntelliSense. The second header will be the API key. I'll just keep it as API key. And the value will be the Azure Cognitive Search key. Let me go to the portal to get this value. So I am back to Search Service. Under the settings sections, there are the keys. And I can get any of the two keys. Both of them have the same permissions or can be only query keys. In my case, I want to create a data source, so I need the management permissions. I copy one of those, go back to Postman, and here is the key that I'm going to use to connect to my resource. Now, for the body, we'll use row to integrate all the definition for this data source. Starting with the name, this is going to be my demo data, followed by a description, this is optional. I will include the description indicating this is the demo files to demonstrate cognitive search capabilities. Perfect. Also include the type of data source. This is an Azure blob. Include the credentials to that source, to this Azure blob. and within the credentials, the connection string. Let me add in camel case. This is my connection string. Here I will add the connection string in a moment. I'll go to the storage account and get it. Also, we are connected to the storage account, but it is for blocks, so I need to indicate the container, the specific container where it's going to extract all this data. And for the container, include, there it is, the name of the container. I will work with the demo data I already have. I'm not sure the name of the container, I'll check it in the portal. So let me go back to the portal. I'll access through the resource group. Here is my storage account. First, I need the connection string. We get the connection string from the settings sections in the access keys. And same thing, I can get one of the two connection strings. Both of them have the same permissions. So back to Postman, I add the connection string that contains the name of the storage account and the key. Also, I need to go for the container name. So back in the actual portal under the storage account, there is the blob service. And underneath the containers, this is the name I'm going to use, the sample data. Let me replace the value. There it is. So this data source called demo data is an Azure blob, have the connection string to the storage account and the specific container from where we want to retrieve the data. And where is going to create this data source? Well, we are sending the name of the resource and also the key to have the permissions to connect directly to our resource. Once we're finished, now I can send the request. Perfect. Now we have a 201. This is what we want to get. It is created. To double check, we can come back to the portal. Let me close this blade. Go back to the search service and double check we already have our other data source. Actually, now we have two. The one created in previous lab, and now we have a second one. I can access to data sources and check. Here is the new one, the demo data created before, with connection string, the specific container from where it's getting the data. Perfect. With this, we finish, we complete this task creating the data source. Now, what we are going to do also using Postman is create a skill set. Therefore, I'll close this blade in order to go back to my search service and get the URL. As mentioned, we'll use Postman to create a skill set, to use the put method. Now, I will access to Postman, create a new request, and paste my URL. First, the method. I will use put. Secondly, the endpoint. I will be working with a skill set / demos skill set. And the parameter, the same one, the API version, I will be using the same version. 2019-05-06-preview. For the header, we'll be using the same headers from the previous request. One is the content type, application JSON, and the second is API key. I will use the same value for our Azure search. Let me go to the other tab to get the key. We are connecting to the same Azure search. Now, in the body, also using row, we'll start creating the four skill sets that we are going to include for our Azure search. That will be language detection, split skill, entity recognition, and key phrase. But before I'll start with a description of this skill set that I'm integrating. And in the description, basically is extract entities, detect language, and extract key phrases. Also, I will include the list of all the skills I want to integrate. So I go for skills, and since there are going to be four, I add within the square bracket. First one, indicating the add all data type, all data dot type. First one is going to be Microsoft skills with capital skills text. We are specifically from the skills in Microsoft, we are working with the text. We want to extract text, and from the text, the language detection. So we want to work with the language detection skill. For this skill, we need to indicate the inputs, so the text indicating or provide the text we want to detect language. In our case, only one single input called text. And this input, sorry, is between the curly braces, there it is. And within this input, the source. Their source will be, from the data source we created before, the path document content. So the content property, we want to get the text and detect the language. Only one input. Now, for the outputs, also for this example will be only one single output called language coach, and the target name will be also language code. From the content of the document, I want to detect the language. One is detected, it's going to send it to the language code property. This is my first skill. I will go and add a second skill. For this second skill, we'll just copy and paste and modify what I need. So let me go to the second. First of all, the data type is Microsoft skills text, but this time, a split skill. Now we work with the split skill. And to work with the split skill, we need to specify the mode. So I indicate the text with camel case, text split mode. The mode we are going to use is pages. Also, specify the maximum page length. The maximum page length, I'll keep it with number, it's going to be 4,000. And then we can work with the inputs. I already have one input. It's going to be the same input. The content, from the content, we want to do a split skill, but to use this endpoint, also we need to specify the code. So I will add a second input. This is going to be the name. And this input, the second input, will be language code. Also indicate the source of this input. And the source will be, this time document, but now the new existing language code. And for the output, will be the text items, we are splitting, so now it's a text items, and the target name will be the pages. So second skills, split skill, we split by pages, maximum 4,000. The input is from the content and indicating what is the language, and the output into the pages, the name text items. Okay, I go for a third skill set. Also paste the previous one. In this third skill set, now also we work with Microsoft skills text, but this time it is an entity recognition. Now we want to work with the entity recognition. To work with entity recognition, specify the categories, and the categories we'll use now is only the organization. There will be only organization categories. Also indicate the default language code. So we are only going to work for this skill set with English. Also indicate the context from where we are going to work. And the context is the same one we've been using, document, but this time pages and everything we have, everything we send to the pages. That will be the context we'll use for the entity recognition. The input, only one input, text, but this time the pages and everything within the pages. The output will be the organizations, and the target name also organizations. So now we have a third skill, entity recognition, the categories only organization, the default language call only English, context from pages, input is the text from the pages, the output the organizations, and will be called, the target name will be organizations. Perfect. Now I'll go for a fourth skill, the last one. Also, I'm going to paste the code. This last skill will be for key phrase extraction. So let me change. Will be also Microsoft skills text key phrase extraction skill. Also within this skill set will include the context, and the context also it is going to be the document pages. Then the list of the input, the text again will be from the pages. And I will add a second input, similar as with the other skill, indicate first the name is the language code, and also indicate the source. This is going to be the document language code. So from the pages, this language code, then I want to get the key phrases. And the output, as you may guess, is the key phrases. The target name, I also going to call it key phrases. Here is where we want the output for this skill set. Okay, so we have four skill sets. Language detection from the content, the output in the language code. Split skill, mode pages up to 4,000 of length. From the content in the language we specify, and it's going to bring it into the pages. And entity recognition, the category organization, English from document pages, the source from the pages, and the output into the organization. And finally, key phrase extraction also from the document pages, also indicating the language code. And all the key phrases are going to be sent to the key phrases. And we finish the section of the skills. I'm going to add another property after the skills. And now working with the cognitive service, the cognitive services that we want to use to detect all these skills. So also need to indicate the old data type. And this time, also using hashtag, will be this check me, check. It's good I use the hashtag now because I see I didn't add it before. Pretty sure I did, but anyway, I'm going to add it now. It's hashtag Microsoft Skills text and then the endpoint for or the skill for each one. Okay, so I go again. Now the last one, as mentioned, is the cognitive services. So also using Microsoft, but this time working with Azure Search Cognitive Services and then specifically by key. Cognitive Services by key. This is the data type. Optionally add the description. This is going to be my cognitive service or connecting to my cognitive service, and as specified, I want to connect using the key. Let me go back to the portal to get this key. I'm in the Azure Search. I will access to the resource group. In the previous lab, we created this cognitive service. Here it is. I will access, this is the one I want to use to have the text extraction, the key phrase, the split, the language detection, etc. Under the resource management from my cognitive services, I'll go to the keys and endpoints and get one of the two keys. Both of them have the same permissions. Go back to Postman and paste here the key. Now be aware, this is the key for the cognitive service used to detect all the skills in this skill set. Under the header, the key we added is for the Azure Search, where we want to add this skill set. So these are the two different keys that we are going to use. Now, I will send the request to create this skill set with all these four skills from my cognitive service. Okay. I already got the 201, my skill set was created. So what is next is check it in the Azure portal. I'm still in cognitive services, let me close. I'm back to the resource group, and from the resource group access to the search service. Within the search service, I'll go to the skill set. And now I have two skill sets, the second one with the four skills included in the JSON. Let me access. And we can check from here the resource used to connect. Also the definition, basically this is everything that we created from the JSON to send the request through Postman. Okay, so now we have a new data source, a new skill set, both of them sent using our JSON definition, using Postman. Now, the next task is to create the index. So now we're going to create the index schema where we specify all the fields, including the attributes to indicate if it's searchable, if we are going to filter, if we're going to make it retrievable, sourceable, and so forth. So, to do this, we are going to create the JSON specifying all the different properties for each field and using Postman with the put method to send the request to create our resource. First, the first thing to do is create a new request. So I also need the URL. Go back to Postman. I'm going to create a new, open a new tab and send the endpoint. As mentioned, the request is going to be a put. Now, the endpoint, our resource.search.windows.net, but this time working with the indexes. So now we're going to work with the indexes. And from the indexes, it's going to be a demo index. This time I don't have a typo like before. I had the demo skill set a typo. So now I'm going to create the demo index. The property API version, we are going to use the same version, 2019-05-06-preview. For the header, also we are going to use the same headers that we've been using in the previous request. The first one is the content type and the value application JSON. And the second one is API key and the value, the key from our Azure Cognitive Search. So let me go back to one of those, access to the headers to get the key. I could have also gone to the portal, but well, I already have it here. Oops, I didn't copy. Let me try again. There it is. So this is the key for my Azure Cognitive Search. And well, the two headers that we have available. Next, in the body, in the request body, also working with Row, I'm going to start creating the JSON to add all the fields we need. So we'll start with the fields section. It's a set of fields. I'm working with the square bracket and start with the first one, indicating the name. The name is ID. This is my first field, ID. The data type for this field is going to be EDM string. So I want to work with a string for my ID. Indicating this is a key, so you send through. And now all the attributes I want to have for this key. Example, I want to make it searchable and specify true. I don't want to make it filterable, so I can explicitly indicate I don't want it as filterable. And indicate this is false. So I have searchable through, filterable false. For faceable, I will specify that yes, I want to, sorry, that no. Also, because this is the ID, so I don't want to make it faceable. And for now, also sourceable. I want to indicate that yes, I want to source based on the ID. So only searchable and sourceable. By the way, if we don't add the retrievable, by default is true. If we don't want to make it retrievable, then we explicitly need to indicate false. This is my first field. I go for the second. Same as before, what I'm going to do is copy and paste and just change the values. My second field is going to be the blob URI. Also, it's going to be a string. Now it's not going to be a key, so I don't need this anymore. Searchable, yes. Filterable, no. Faceable, no. And sourceable, yes. So basically, same attributes. The only difference is that this is not the key. I go for a next field. My next field is going to be the content. Remember, for the key phrases, the language detection, we were using the content. Also a string. Now, for this field, searchable is going to be through. Filterable, I keep it as false. Faceable, also false. And sourceable, also false. So I don't want the content as sourceable. Go for my next field. This time is going to be other field that we were using within the skill set, the language code. I use it with camel case, language code. The type also is a string, searchable, true, filterable, I leave it as false, faceable, I leave it as false, and I don't even add the sortable. I keep it just with these three. By default, there are false. Also, the only exception is retrievable, by default is true. I go for my next field. Also, we use within the skills, the key phrases. And remember, the key phrases were a collection, so now I'm going to change the type, indicating this is a collection of strings for the key phrases. This is a collection of strings, searchable, through, filterable, keep it as false, faceable, keep it as false, and I don't even going to add the sortable. Need one more. The organizations also used within the skills we were adding before. So the organizations, as we saw, it was also for the key detection, therefore also this is going to be a collection of strings. Searchable, through, filterable, no, faceable, false, and sortable, I'll keep it also as false. It explicitly indicate that this is going to be false. So this is everything I need for my index that I want to create. So this is the whole definition, the whole index schema we need, where the data is going to be added from the data source and also using the skill set. So finally, I'm just going to click on send. Wait for the result, and I got again my 201. So I already created the index. And we can check it again going back to the portal, I mean the Azure search. If I come to the indexes and refresh, now I have my new index, it's still empty because I haven't connected the data source to the index. I just created the schema with the fields and the attributes for each field. But so far, if I access to the index, I can, well, if I go to search, it's still empty, but if I go to the fields to check the schema, I already have the schema defined within the application. As mentioned, by default, everything is retrievable unless we indicate false. So here are all the sortable. A collection couldn't be sortable, that's why I didn't add this attribute within the JSON definition. Perfect, let me close this blade. So now we have a new data source, a skill set, and an index. What is next? Create the indexer to map the fields and execute the transformation. The indexer is going to map our data source with the index and also execute the transformations that detect the language, the key phrases, etc. So that will be our next step. Okay, to start working with it, also we need our URL. Also, we are going to work with Postman using our definition, creating the definition with JSON. So I'm going to open a new tab. Sending the endpoint. The endpoint is the same URL from our resource, this time with the indexers. This time working with indexers. And the name of the indexer, demo indexer. Same parameter, the API version. I have a typo there. API version will be using the same version. 2019.05.06 preview. The method also will be a put. We want to create a new indexer, a new resource. For the header, same keys and value first one was our content type, application JSON. The second one was the API key, and the value, the key from the service. This time I go to the portal. Remember, from the search service, under the settings, there are the keys, and get one of the two keys. There it is. And for the body, also using the row option, and include the schema, the JSON definition for the indexer. So let me start. First, indicating the data source name. The data source will be the name, let me come to this request, the name we specify, in this case, the demo data I specify for my source name. So I'm going to double check I have the valid names. I can check it here in this request from Postman, or back to the portal, in the overview, I can come to the data source and check this is my demo data. I need the target index name, so under indexes, I will use the demo index. Let me go for the target index name. Also, I'm going to copy and paste. This is the index name, demo index. Demo index. And the skill set, in case we have, in our case, we created a skill set. So I also need the skill set name. Here is where I have the type one, that's why I wanted to copy and paste. So I have, I preserve the same value. My, instead of demo, is dems skill set. Okay? Here we are mapping the data source with the target index and making some transformation optionally using the skill set name. What is next? To create the field mappings. So now I go for the field mappings. So it can be several. I start with a square bracket and then go by one by one. First one, provide the source field name. The first one is going to be from the data source, my source field name, metadata storage path, the target field name. So one of the fields created in the index, the ID. And also the mapping function. The mapping function for this field, it's going to be a base64 encoded. So I can check, let me go back to the data source. Based on the data that we are reading from this storage account, reading from this container, are going to be all the source field, name. And for the target field name will be from the index, all the different fields that we created in the schema definition. And well, in this case, just the mapping function using the base64 encoded. I go for a second one. For now, I'm just going to copy and paste these two parameters and just change the values. Second one is from the source, from the data source content for the target. Also, we created a field called content. I go for the next one. The data source, the source field name, is going to be the metadata storage path. So same one. Metadata storage path. And the target, the blob URI. So basically, blob URI and ID are going to have the same value because it's our same source. Only with this, only from the source, we want to read this. Remember, we have other fields in the target, but again, from the source, we just want to get the path in the ID and the blob URI and the content itself from our files. Now, I'll go for another property, the output field mappings. Same thing, it's going to be a set of fields. Start with the first one, also same names, the source field name. Now I want to get from the organization's read. So we'll start with document, pages, and then all the pages, and from there the organizations, and then all the organizations. This is the source from the skill set, and the target will be the organizations created in the index. I'll go for the second one. The source field name is documents, pages, this time the key phrases, and everything from key phrases, and then the target from the index will be into the key phrases. And finally, the last one, remember, the language code. The language code will be from our source document language code. So these are the three output field mappings using the skill set, using our data source, then transform this from our skill set to send it to the index. Okay, so we finish with the output field mappings. And now I will add parameters. So I go for the parameters. And in the parameters indicate, one of those is the maximum failed items we want to accept. So maximum failed items we have is -1. We don't want to accept failed items. The maximum failed items per batch. And the maximum failed items per batch, also I'm going to keep it with -1. Also, we'll modify the configuration. So for the configuration, include the data to extract and the data to extract from the content and metadata. Content and metadata. Also, the image action. And the image action will be generate normalized images. Perfect. So these are the parameters, the properties I want to include within the indexer. And as we can see, the indexer is doing the map between our data source and the index and our skill set and the index. So it's executing transformation from the data source to include, to transform with the entities, the key phrases, the language code into our index. That will be all. Now I'm going to execute this request. Okay, let me check what I got this 400 bad request. It seems fine. Ah, I can see here, I have a typo, it's field. Also here is encode. And so far, everything else seems fine. Let me send it again. Perfect. Sorry about that, there were some typos. 201. Okay, now, in order to validate that everything is correct, can go back to the Azure portal. Let me refresh it. specifically to the indexers, and now I have one indexer. The demo indexer hasn't run, so I still don't have any documents. Let me access to this indexer. We can check under the settings everything specified, like the maximum failed items and per batch, the data to extract, also the definition, in case later we want to modify something. Well, here is the whole definition of what was created. Let me close this. As we can see, the indexer is in progress, so it's retrieving the data. We need to wait for a moment. I'm going to pause the video, and when it's finished, I will start recording. It is still in progress, it's been 10 minutes, but now we can see already, it's already uploading documents. Actually, we can also see it in the index. We already have 3 documents. Let me access. And send a search. So now we can start checking the data from the source. From the source, we set the ID and the blob URI. We specify the content. And from the skill set, the language code. So this is in Spanish, the key phrases, and the organizations for each one of the documents. This other in English, and also each one of the features. Now, what I want to do is to work with Postman to send a request using Postman. Let me close this blade. I'll get the URL and go to Postman, create a new request, and paste this URL. This request is to get the schema of the index, so I will keep it as a get. Also, beside to be a get, I need to send the whole endpoint. So it will be in the indexes, the name of the index, my index is called demo index, and the API version, I will be using the same version. Beside that, I need to work with the headers already created, the content type, and the API key. Same, actually this should be JSON. So application JSON for content type, API key, the key of my resource, my Azure Cognitive Search. Once I'm ready, I can send it, wait for the answer. And the answer, as mentioned, is the schema of my index. Each one of the fields with the attributes for each one of those. I can go and create a second request, also a get request, but this time, also for my index, this time I want to get the data, the documents. So that will be indexes, the name of the index, demo index, and we'll add for the endpoint the docs, the documents. After that, the search. What I want to search, everything or specific keywords, and the API version will be the same. For the headers, we'll add the same headers that I've been using, the content type, application JSON, and API key. Need to go for the key of my resource. So let me go to another request, get the key, and paste it. So that will be my second request. I can send again. And now I get all the data based on the search, in this case everything, and all, I didn't add a select, so all the fields with no filters, everything I have within my index. So now we finish our lab. What we did, work with the data source, skill set, index, an indexer, but using JSON, using Postman. And once we created all our structure, search, consume the Azure Search Index, also using Postman. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this lab. If you've got the time, feel free to join our next lab.